push this game to Northfield. And, you know, we've had so much weather and so many delays of this basketball game. They just had to get it in. Plus, oh, by the way, the sectional starts on Tuesday, and he just had to find a place to play, and Northfield is gracious enough to let us play here. So it'll be Hampton and Pollock jump center, and the tip is controlled by Cromer for the Wabash Lady Apaches. Wabash in their home white, Rochester in their road black. Wabash going to our right. Dan Bailey, I'm David Musselman. They get it across the timeline to Puckett, who gives off to Lewis. Lewis drives it to the elbow. Outside to Puckett, who holds above her head. Now to Lewis. Lewis back to Puckett. Drives it into the paint. Backs away and throws up a shot over Pollock. Off the glass. Good. Wabash strikes first. 30 seconds gone in the ball game. It's 2-0. Lob pass down low to B. B backs away in against Hampton. She has her shot blocked. Keaton Stasiak picks it up, puts it off the glass, and good. And we're tied at 2. Offensive rebound for Rochester to put back by Stasiak. With 7:15 to play in the first quarter, it's 2-2. Thomas gives him the corner to Puckett. Puckett hands the ball above her head. Gives to Hampton from the elbow extended. Shot no good. And the rebound to Becky Malko. Rochester runs to our left. Malko then accelerates, drives it to the baseline. And then we're going to have a foul against Puckett. Makes that against Thomas on the block, which I think that Kylie Hampton, Dan, probably could have picked one up easily that last time down the floor in the Swan.
You can definitely see offensively Rochester trying to be aggressive and attack the Wabash key players. That's a good strategy on the offensive end.
So Rochester with the basketball after the inbound pass. Murphy has it, drives it, throws it up off the glass. No good. Pollock with the rebound. Her put back is blocked by Hampton. And B. Pollock will go to the line to shoot 2.
Great work on the offensive boards early in the game, getting several opportunities for offensive possession.
And that's exactly what happened on the last trip down for Rochester. Hampton swatted it just like that, but this time called for the personal foul. 6:48 to play, first quarter with tied at 2. B. Pollock for Rochester at the line to shoot 2 for her Lady Zebras. Pollock eyes the first one, lets it fly. It's no good up in front of the rim and falls off.
It's going to be so important for Pollock and Carly to stay aggressive in there. You get a couple shots blocked. Sometimes players get shy, and they shy away from that.
And we've seen that this year. You're right. Pollock's second one is good as it falls over the front of the rim. Rochester up 3-2. Cromer in the backcourt against Holland. Cromer over the top of the defense to Thomas. Thomas in the left corner to Lewis. Lewis now on the baseline to Puckett. Puckett a couple of dribbles. Gives to Hampton above her head. Now to Lewis. Lewis holds. Now to Puckett to the elbow. Just inside the arc. Her jumper's off the mark. No good. Follows the shot. Puts it back. It's good. Well, you tell the youngsters nowadays, shoot and follow. And that's exactly what Puckett did there. 4-3 Wabash. 6:18 to play in the first quarter. Lob pass down low to Pollock. Here she's blocked from behind. Stasiak to follow. Her shot good. Team Stasiak has 2 offensive boards and 4 points. And Rochester back up right now 5-4.
Lewis. 3 offensive possessions for Rochester, and all 3 have an offensive rebound.
Absolutely. Lob pass to Puckett just behind the arc. Holds. Cross-court pass to Thomas. Thomas back to Puckett at the free throw line. Looks down low to Hampton. Can't find her. Now to Thomas. Thomas in paint. Rises up. Puts a shot up. It's good. Wabash back up 6-5. Rochester on the run going to our left. 5:40 to play in the first quarter. Becky Malko runs to the right side. Feeds down low to B. B against the double team. Has a pass stolen by Cromer. Cromer runs for the Lady Apaches up by 1. To Thomas. Thomas in the paint. And she is going to be called for, or a foul is going to be called on Rochester as she was in the lane. It'll be out of bounds to the Lady Apaches.
Defensively, you can definitely see Rochester trying to take a couple key players out. They're playing a little gimmick, box into or triangle into, whatever you want to call it. But it is disrupting the Lady Apaches' flow.
Pass comes in to the Wabash Lady Apaches. Bucket jumper's no good. Holland runs down a loose rebound and runs. Holland middle of the floor for the Lady Zebras, running to our left. 6-5 Wabash. X, long three for the Lady Zebras off the mark. No good. And the rebound to Thomas. Thomas runs to the Lady Apaches through the center circle. Now the right elbow gives him the baseline to Ritter, who's back at the basketball game, or is in the basketball game. Now to Cromer. Outside to Thomas. 18-footer, top of the key. Nope. Pollock with the rebound. B gives off to Malko. Rochester runs down by 1, under 5 to play the first quarter. Malko picks away through traffic, is fouled, going to the basket by Thomas. It'll be out of bounds to the Lady Zebras. Coach Bumgarner will go back to the bench and send in Shelby Stone, a 5'6 junior. And Stone will replace Thomas for the Wabash Lady Apache. Dan Bailey, I'm David Musselman. 6:52 to play in the first quarter. Wabash up 6-5. Rochester basketball to bounce baseline left. Holland, what's triggered in? Bounce pass into B. B in the paint. Out to Malco. Malco fakes a shot, drives, cut off, loses it to Stasiak. Key in a couple of dribbles. Bounce pass top of the key to Murphy. Murph works right side. Wrap around pass to Pollock, top of the key. Lob pass down low to Stasiak, and it goes out of her hands and out of bounds and go back to Wabash on a turnover by the Lady Zebras.
This is a little thing, but that is a turnover that Rochester can defend. Or they're trying to get the ball into the paint. It goes out of bounds. Now they get a chance to set their defense.
Well, like you said, they got to take advantage of every opportunity when they've got the basketball. And now we're going to have a legal screen on Cromer, and it's going to go to the Rochester Lady Zebras on another Wabash turnover. 4:27 to play, first quarter. Rochester trails the Wabash Lady Apache 6-5 here at Northfield High School. Becky Malcolm will bring it up for the Lady Zebras. Man-to-man defense by the Wabash Lady Apache. Malco behind the arc right side. Feeds down low to Stasiak. Loses the handle. Pete picks it up. Gives out to Malco. Long three off the back of the rim. No good. And the rebound tipped around and knocked out of bounds by Rochester. And it'll go back to Wabash. Rochester's had some pretty good looks from behind the arc. And like last time they were here on Saturday, can't get them to fall. Or Friday, that is. Can't get them to fall. 4:10 to play. First quarter. 6-5. Wabash. Puckett. Backs her way in. Throws it back outside to Stone. Stone a couple of dribbles to Puckett. Looks for a cutting Hampton. Nice stop by Stasiak to Cromer. Cromer drives. Down low to a wide open Stone. A Ritter. Her jumper's good. Sarah Ritter, the 5'7 sophomore. Makes it a 5'7 junior, has her first bucket of the night. And now Wabash up by 3, 8-5 with 3:40 to play in the first quarter. X against Cromer. Picks up a dribble, gives him the baseline. DeMalco has her pass stripped away and stolen by Cromer. Cromer pushes for the Lady Apaches. Up by 3. Cromer in the paint. Stops. Leaner off the glass is no good, but I believe B. Pollock has picked up foul number 2. And that's going to send Coach Stasiak to the bench right now to bring in Bailey Abbott. Again, B. Pollock has picked up foul number 2 with 3.5 to play in the first quarter. So Claire Cromer, the second leading scorer in the conference, at the line for 2. First was good for the juniors. We'll have one more. And Abbott is in, and probably Dan Bailey will be on the bench here for a while.
Those last two possessions for Rochester is exactly what they have to stay away from. You know, quick turnovers, come down the other end, and all of a sudden you're down 5.
And so your biggest post threat is on the bench with 2 fouls. Could add insult to injury. X in the lane. Floater on the way. Line of contact. No foul. Offensive rebound to Abbott. Al Stasiak to Murphy. 3 on the way. Top of the key. Nope. No good. And the rebound to Stone. Gives to Cromer. Cromer around the defense to Stone. She crosses the timeline right. Thrown down a bucket about 15 feet away from the basket. She'll pull up and shoot over Abbott. It's no good. And the rebound to Bailey. Abbott gives to Murphy. Rochester runs down by 5. 3 minutes to play first quarter. Malco in the paint. Down low to Stasiak. And Stasiak makes that. Abbott loses it out of bounds, and they go back to Wabash. Back in the Wabash lineup is Jacqueline Lewis, and she'll replace Puckett for Scott Bumgarner's group.
3 out of the 4 last possessions for Rochester have been turnovers, and that's where Wabash has stretched the lead out.
I was going to say, and probably those 3 turnovers have turned into some kind of points for Wabash. Stone at the elbow, jumper, nope, too hard. Offensive rebound to Wabash. Outside to Hampton, top of the key. Right side to Lewis, feet on the line, cut long jumper short. Stasiak with the rebound. Keaton runs for Rochester. Right side of the floor, down by 5. Stasiak coast to coast, layup is no good. The rebound fall for Adam comes out of there, out to X. 15-footer left side is short, and the rebound to Hampton from Wabash. Lewis now with the rebound. Lewis has her pass stolen by Malco. Malco right-handed layup, no good, but a foul coming on Jacqueline Lewis. That's going to send Malco to the line to shoot one and make that 2 shots.
Such a heady play by Malco, sneaking in, stealing that outlet pass. The Lady Apache's looking to get out and run and push, and Malco did a great job of sneaking in there and going strong to the basket.
2:22 to play in the first quarter. Rochester down 10-5. Malco with the line to shoot two for her Lady Zebras. First was good. She'll have one more. Dan Bailey, I'm David Musselman. We're at Northfield High School. Final conference game of the year for Wabash. Rochester has one more. That's on Saturday. Second one short. Hampton the board gives to Cromer. It'll be senior night on Saturday for the Rochester Lady Zebras. Lewis outside to Stone. Stone holds the basketball. Gives to Lewis. Long jumper short. And the rebound to Malco. Malco runs for Rochester. Malco then pulls it back outside. X on the left wing. Holland accelerates in the paint. Stasiak drives the baseline, throws him a shot. It's good. Keaton Stasiak out 6 of the 8 points. It's 10-8 Wabash. 1:50 to play in the first quarter. Wabash quickly breaks the man-to-man press and gives to Lewis, to Stone, in the paint, to Hampton. Layup, good. Hampton answers the Stasiak bucket to push the lead back to 4 with 1.5 minutes to play in the first quarter. Murphy, Herliner on the way. A lot of contact. Bailey Evans blocked from behind by Cromer. And now we're going to have a jump ball, and it's going to go to Rochester.
Hampton's been held pretty quiet thus far. She's being face guarded by Stasiak and Malco off and on. And they've done a pretty good job. She got loose on a little back cut there.
They give up about 4 or 5 inches, but doing a great job on Hampton, their by far go-to player this year for the Wabash Lady Apaches. Minute 20 to play, first quarter, 12-8 Wabash. Murphy behind the arc in the wing. Murphy looking, gives top to Malco. Becky against the man-to-man defense, gives to Murphy right side. Murph back to Malco with a minute 10. Malco drives in the paint, rises up off the window, good! 12-10, Wabash on top, Kroeber the basketball against the double team. Works across the timeline. Thomas gives the stone to Hampton. Back to Cromer, the 52nd. Cromer drives. Shot over Murphy is good. Claire Cromer, just a junior with 2 more, and pushes the lead back to 4 for Wabash with 38 seconds to play in the opening quarter here at Northfield High School. Malco around the defense. Kicks it back outside to X with 30. Holland hands off to Malco with 29. Becky in the paint. Out to Murphy with 27. Murph against Hampton. Holds. Looks back to Stasiak. Has the play with 19. Bounce pass to Malco in the center circle with 16. Becky holds with 14. With 12 now. Becky still holding in the center circle with 10. Wabash up 14-10 as the first quarter coming to a close. To X with 5. Holland with 3 on the way is no good, in and out. Rebound to Puckett, that'll do it for the first quarter. After 1, Wabash lead, 14-10. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here, we get our tires here. Oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains.
Back at Northfield High School, we go to the second quarter right now. The Wabash Lady Apaches leading 14-10. And Dan, you hit it on the head.
Part of Rochester's past,
you said at the
present,
break,
and future.
Coach Stasiak probably pleased with this 14, except this 14-10 lead, because it could have been ugly if that 10-5 lead the Wabash had gets away from them.
Well, the positive for Rochester is that I think they're getting the Wabash players to shoot the ball that they want to shoot the ball. And Rochester's getting good looks. They're not knocking them down, but they're getting good looks offensively.
And you talked about that gimmick defense, and Rochester in one right now is that triangle and two working to this point. That shot missed by Thomas, and Becky Malco with the rebound to X. Holland out to Malco, left side to Murph. Murph holds the basketball, now to Stasiak, just in there. She drives out to Holland for 3, right wing. Good! And Rochester cuts into this Wabash lead. It's 14-13 Lady Apache, 7:25 to play in the first half. Stone gives to cutting Hampton. Outside to Thomas. Couple of dribbles at the free throw line. She gives the puck into the elbow. Down low to Hanson. Back to Wayne to give her Stasiak. Jumper's good. Boy, you let Hanson get the ball that deep, it doesn't matter how tall you are, you're not going to stop it.
I got to believe that's a coaching adjustment at the quarter. You know, she's got 6 or 7 inches on her defender right now.
Coaching by Wallback.
Wallback, yeah.
Holland, teardrop shot from the baseline short. And the rebound's knocked out of bounds by Bailey Abbott. It'll go back to Wabash. 16-13. Wabash on top with just under 7 minutes of play here in the first half. Dan Bailey, I'm David Musselman. Stone with it. Now runs a point to Wabash. Still wide open. Thomas, he does not take the shot. Gives to Stone. Stone drives to the free throw line. Out to Kroemer for three. Good. And now the lead is 6 for Wabash in 19-13. Rochester with it going to our left. Malco backs in, gives out to Holland. Hex at the free throw line. She backs it back outside and will reset for Rochester. Give to Malco. Malco in the paint. Backs away and out to Holland. 3 for the Lady Sabres. No good. Hex has the rebound. Throws it up. No good off the bound of the backboard. Wabash picks it up. Stone has it. Now to Kroemer. Throws it out of bounds. That's a tough shot.
You can definitely see an adjustment on Wabash's side. First two possessions out, two of their three main players come out, and they make an effort to get the ball to them, and they make good scoring plays. So definitely see the adjustments going on.
6 minutes to play, first half. Wabash up by 6. Malcolm in the paint, out to Murph. Charlie in the lane, throws up a shot. I believe Hampton just picked up foul number 2, and Murph will go to the line to shoot 2. That's exactly what Coach Stasiak hoped to happen. So 6 minutes to play in the first half. Rochester will be at the free throw line from here on out, and Carly Murphy will be there to shoot free throws. Murph eyes the first one. Let the fly. No good. And I tell you what, you know, we've kind of already touched on this a little bit, Dan. When the clock has stopped, Rochester's an opportunity to score. They got to do it.
Absolutely. These are those opportunities that, you know, when you get them against a quality team like Wabash, you have to make the most of it.
Charlie's second one, good this time. 19-14, Wabash. Deep pause with 2 fouls back into the game. Murphy to sit.
Now, this is going to be a really interesting stretch here. Hampton has 2 for Wabash. Pollock has 2 for Rochester. 2 very important players on both sides.
And she stayed in the game, did Hampton. It surprised me a little bit. Thomas runs the baseline, moves the footing, rolls over the ball, no call, out of Stone. Stone gives down low to Kroemer. She is ran over by Stasiak. And it'll be out of bounds to Wabash. 5:46 to play, first half. Wabash up 19-14. Coach Stasiak asking for travel. Coach Bumgarner's asking why isn't that on the shot. Thomas, lob pass over the defense to Stone. Stone holds and studies, gives it to Thomas in the corner. Thomas now the left elbow goes to Puckett. Puckett over her head to Hampton. Long three, left wing. Good. You give her a lot of time to look at it. Actually, she doesn't need a lot of time, and Coach Stasiak will use a 30-second timeout. Wabash up by 8. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Back at Northfield High School, Rochester trying to stop the momentum right now. It is all on Wabash's side as they now lead by 8, the biggest lead of the game.
Now, Hampton has come out at the quarter. Looks a little bit different. She looks a little more aggressive, and she's making some big plays right now for Wabash.
I know she's got 5 points here in the last couple of minutes. Stasiak behind the arc on the right wing. Now top of the key for Rochester. Crossover dribble goes to the paint. Feet pass down those behind it, cutting Bailey Abbott out of bounds. And we go back to Wabash after another turnover. 5:16 to play in the first half. 22-14 Wabash with an opportunity here to go up by double digits. Triangle and 2 by the Rochester Lady Zebras. Stone holds it with the ball above her head. Down the corner to Thomas. Thomas gives it to Kroemer on the right wing. Or runs away from the defense. Throws up a shot over to Pollock. It's no good. Good block out by Abbott, who gives to Malco. Rochester runs down by 8. 4:50 to play in the first half. Malco inside the arc. Kicks it back outside to Holland. Holland now resets outside the volleyball line. Now high on the right side for Rochester. Bounce pass to Malco. Malco gets a pick from Pollock. In the paint now is Rochester. And Malco throws up a shot at the free throw line. It's off the back of the rim and in. 22-16 Wabash.
Kind of surprised herself there coming around that screen wide open.
She was wide open, you're right. Stone, bounce past the bucket in the corner to Thomas. 18-footer left baseline, good. Tell you what, if they start heating up without Hampton, look out.
Well, I tell you, Rochester's still getting, you know, they're getting the right people to shoot the basketball.
Yeah.
Hampton's gotten off a little bit here in the quarter, but for the most part, they're forcing the Wabash players that they want to shoot the ball.
Holland for three, short. Holland with a little rebound. The putback is good. 24-18. Yeah, 24-16 maybe. And
great
now Rochester steals it. B. Pollock, layup on the way, is no good. Hampton got away with the first third foul. And now Kramer has it. Gives it head to Puckett. Puckett in the paint. Backs her way in. Throws him a shot over Pollard. Makes that habit is good. 26-18. Wabash on top with 3:20 to play in the first half. Holland on the right wing. Back to Malco. Stays behind the arc on the left side. Now on the baseline to Abbott. Cross court right wing to Holland. Three on the way again for X. Is off the back. The iron no good. Abbott with a rebound. Throws it out of bounds. And it'll go back to Wabash.
Boy, I tell you, unofficially, Rochester is absolutely controlling the rebound war. That's 8 or 9,
yeah.
I think, offensive rebounds in this half. And they just haven't been able to capitalize on them.
3 minutes to play, first half. Wabash by eight. And they've got the basketball going to our right. Stone just inside the arc. Back to back outside. Now top of the key to Kramer. Kramer back to Stone on the right side. Stone gives to Thomas. Her jumper at the free throw line. No good. Gets the roll rebound. The putback is no good. And Malco is aboard. Malco brings it up quickly for Rochester. Going to our left. Stop. Pop. Jumper from the free throw line is good. 26-20, 2:35 to play in the first half.
That's the second time she's got to that free throw line, just wide open.
Well, I think you know as well as I do that there's not going to be much action in the paint tonight for Rochester. And then Holland picks the pocket of Stone. Holland, left side of the floor, left-handed layup is off the glass, no good. And now we're going to have a foul coming on Rochester. Is that going to be on Holland? Left-handed layup wide open is too hard. And no, it's going to be on Malco.
One thing I think Rochester can exploit a little bit, Wabash has been getting the ball out of Cromer's hands a little bit, maybe trying to give her a little bit of break up against the pressure, but she's their point guard for a reason, and when you put the ball in someone else's hands, it's susceptible to getting picked like that.
Hampton holds, now to Thomas in the right corner. One dribble to Lewis on the right wing, back to Thomas in the right baseline, and now we're going to have a foul. Is that going to be Abbott? As she tried to run through the Ritter screen, it's going to be out of bounds to Wabash. Baseline right with 2:03 to play in the first half. Lady Apache's leading 26-20. Well, Wabash already has at least a share of the conference championship wrapped up. They don't want to share. The jumper short from the baseline by Lewis, and Murphy the rebound. Murph runs, throws up a shot, hard off the glass, no good, hand from the board, and her pass is stolen by Holland. Heck, between her legs, dribble, and then has her pass knocked out of bounds by Wabash on the far side, and will stay with Rochester.
Well, Rochester is really fortunate right now to only be trailing six.
I was thinking that when they were trailing by eight. 1:45 to play, first half, Rochester down by six. Holland, right side. Top the key to Stasiak. Keaton holds and assesses the situation out of Murphy, quickly to Malcolm on the left baseline. Drives the baseline, and she's going to be fouled on the block by Lewis, and that's going to send Becky Malco to the line for one and the bonus.
Well, this last minute 32 could be huge for Rochester because shooting the bonus, and I really believe that Rochester's guards have caused trouble for Wabash. I mean, they're getting in the lane quite a bit, and they've proven to be very difficult to guard. Rochester can creep back into this thing and maybe even grab a little lead, get within one or two at halftime. I think they'll feel really good about that.
We're 90 seconds from the break. Are you surprised Hampton's still in there with two fouls?
I am absolutely amazed.
Second one from Malco, no good. She goes 1 of 2, and the rebound comes down to Ritter, who gives off to Kramer. Dan Bailey, I'm David Musselman. A minute 25 to play in the first half. Wabash by five. Lead has been as big as eight in this quarter. Thomas to cutting Hanson at the elbow. Outside to Ritter, now to Thomas. Thomas backs it out and resets for Wabash. To Lewis, to Ritter. High on the left side to Cromer, now to Thomas. Looking for Hanson, Hazard. Double teamed, and she throws almost throws the basketball out of bounds. Gives to Lewis. Now top of the key to Thomas in the minute to play in the first half. Boy, they are lost without Hampton touching the basketball.
I think that tells you something about why she's still in with
your right.
Fouls.
Good call.
It also has to tell you how much trust Coach has in her to not pick up number three.
Thomas at the elbow, 40 seconds to play, gives to Lewis. Now to Ritter, now to Lewis, Thomas at his high on the left side. Looking for Hanson, has the top of the key with 35. Hasiak doing a fantastic job on Hanson, who's been virtually quiet this entire half. 20 to play in the first half. Wabash holds. Thomas now dribbles to the middle of the floor. Outside to Lewis with 15. Back to Thomas with 14. 26-21, now to Cromer. Cromer at the elbow, backs it out with 9. Left side to Thomas with 5. Around the defense, pulls up at the free throw line. Is good with 3, with 2, with 1. And a three-quarter court shot at the buzzer, so good. At halftime, Wabash leads 28-21. You're listening to Lady Fever Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle. RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC. We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
Back at the Northfield High School, we start the third quarter. Rochester turns the basketball over, which results in a two-point bucket by the Wabash Apaches. So Rochester now down by 9 with 30 seconds gone in the third quarter. Dan Bailey, I'm David Musselman. And Dan, you were saying that the first 3 minutes here in the second for the third quarter could be crucial for Rochester as B. Pollock gets the dump pass from Holland, puts it up and good. And the lead is back to 7 for Wabash.
Boy, that first possession turnover was not a good start for Rochester. They come back to second possession, though. Good post speed, good post move.
6 turnovers for Rochester in that first half, and just 5 for Wabash. Rochester, you know, we talked a little bit about Rochester's rebounding, out-rebounded Wabash 17-12.
And a lot of those on the offensive end.
Yeah, you're right. Murphy commits her first foul of the game. Thomas looks to trigger it in. Does so to Lewis, now to Puckett. Puckett back to Lewis. 15-footer right baseline's in and out, no good. Malco with a rebound and run. Malco, middle of the floor, runs through the defense. Layup on the way is good. Rochester cuts the lead to 5. Cromer the basketball. Now gives ahead to Thomas through the center circle. Rochester still in that triangle in two. Malco chasing Cromer, Stasiak chasing Hampton. Bucket to Lewis. They're cutting Thomas, pull up, jumper, and the lane is good. Well, for Wabash to win this game, Dan, that's exactly what's going to happen because Rochester did a fantastic job on Cromer and Hampton. Malco at the elbow, almost has it taken away. Now we're going to have a reach-in foul on Cromer. 6:13 to play in the third quarter. Rochester down by 7 at 32-25.
Thomas is doing a great job for Wabash, shouldering the majority of the scoring responsibilities there with the triangle and two defense. She's getting a lot of open looks, and she's knocking them in.
6:10 to play, third quarter. Wabash up 32-25. They have basically led this entire basketball game. Stasiak feeds out to Murph. Murph against Hampton. She's fouled the shot. Hampton just picked up foul number three. Nice job by Keaton Stasiak. You know, we saw a little bit of that offense here on Friday night last week where Keaton Stasiak ran the point, and they did that to take advantage of some matchups, and that's what Murphy did right there.
Well, that's also a way to get Holland going from the outside, too. You get Stasiak, get the penetration in the lane. You know, if Holland's defender helps off at all, then that's an easy inside-out three. All three of the guards for Rochester have been getting into the lane quite a bit.
I agree. Murph hits one or two and cuts the lead to six with 6 minutes to play in the third. And Hampton has picked up her third personal foul. The bucket on the baseline. Off the key to Stone, just inside the arc, jumper off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound tipped around, and off the head of Malcolm out of bounds, and we'll see it's Wabash right in front of their bench.
That defensive possession, you could see a little bit of a change there. They went with a trap down the sideline and got the right person taking a shot, just couldn't come up with the rebound.
Cromer to Stone. Stone, a couple of dribbles, works to the right side, now high on the right side to Cromer. Cromer holds against Malcolm to Hampton to a cutting Stone, outside to Puckett, jumper's good. Rochester doing everything in their power to take away their best two players, what they're doing, and everybody else for Wabash picking up the slack. Malco is going to be fouled before the shot. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester. 5:24 to play in the third. Wabash by eight, and 34-26.
You don't get ranked by just having two good players.
Yeah,
so
you're right.
You know, Rochester's kind of picking their poison right now, and Wabash is doing a great job of their role players and their other players stepping up and knocking in shots.
Murphy takes a tough shot. Defense picks up the rebound. Head to Thomas, now to Hampton, to Puckett on the left baseline. Puckett backs the way in, throws up a shot, no good. Rebound to Malco. Malco runs for Rochester. Rochester's three-on-three break. Dump pass down to Pollock through her legs and out of bounds. That's a tough one to handle right at her ankle. Good idea. 5 minutes to play in the third. Wabash by eight, 34-26.
Absolutely the right play there. Just not executed.
Stone, pass is taken away by Malco. Malco then loses the basketball to bounds. Puckett gets away with a reach-in.
And this is the second possession. Rochester's come out in a 1-3-1 trap, and two possessions in a row. They have gotten a turnover.
Yep. You're right. Stone now runs the point for Wabash. Stone works to the wing. Triangle and two still. And we're going to have a foul on Malco for running through the screen. 4:40 to play in the third. Becky Malco just picked up foul number two. 34-26. I like that, Dan. I really do. He called the foul to the official, and then let Tony vent, and then kind of walked away from it.
You know, it is a frustrating situation, especially for Malco on the floor, because she and Stasiak are getting screened to death, and there's nothing dirty about it. They're trying to get their main scorers open, but it is a frustrating situation for sure.
Cromer misses the basket. Stasiak with the rebound. Stasiak runs the floor, throws him a shot, a lot of contact, no foul, no good. And the rebound to Thomas on the right side. 4:10 to play in the third quarter. Wabash by eight. Puckett backs her way in against Pollock. Outside to Stone. Stone now left wing to Thomas at the elbow. Almost has a pocket pick. Ball loose. Now we're going to have a reach and foul by Holland. And it'll be out of bounds to the far side to the Wabash Lady Apache. .358 to play in the third quarter. Wabash up 34-26. And it'll be out of bounds to the Wabash Lady Apaches on the far side. Gets it into Cromer. Cromer against Malco, works through the left wing. Cromer now down to the baseline, kicks it back outside. Outside to Stone. Stone jumper from the free throw line is too hard. Extra the rebound. Holland runs, left side of the floor, going on to our right. Lob pass by Lutoszczyk. Keaton against the trees. Outside to Holland. X, couple of dribbles, now in the paint, stops, pops, nope. Pollock put back, no good. Pass coming on Hampton, who got all ball, I believe, that time. Oh, no, it's going to be on Puckett, I beg your pardon. Yeah, I thought Hampton got all ball that time, but regardless, it's a foul on Wabash, and that's going to send B. Pollock to the line to shoot two.
You can sense the tension a little bit in the gym. Things are getting a little bit chippy. Seeing a little bit of frustration on the face of the players.
Pollock's free throw is good. And back into the game is Lewis for Wabash, and she'll replace Stone. 3.5 to play in the third. It's a 7-point lead for Wabash. B. Pollock for the Lady Zebras looking to cut this lead to 6. Dan Bailey, I'm David Musselman. Pollock will have one more for Rochester. Eyes the second one, lets it fly, too hard. And Puckett with the rebound, who gives off to Cromer. Wabash up by 7. Their biggest lead of the night has been 9. Could have been more on several opportunities. Puckett on the baseline, jumper over Pollock, no good. And the rebound kept alive by Hampton. Ball loose, and now Thomas has it. And her pass is picked off by Rochester. Holland runs. Holland on the right side is fouled by Thomas. And it'll be out of bounds to the Lady Zebras baseline right with 3:07 to play in the third. Lady Zebras down by 7. Back into the game is Ritter. Also Abbott coming back in for Rochester, and Murphy will sit down.
Boy, I really think the guard play for Rochester is going to play a key here in the last quarter and a half. Wabash has proven to be ineffective at keeping Rochester guards out of the paint, but that's where 90% of Wabash fouls have come.
They have done a fantastic job, has Rochester. With the basketball and the guard down low, Hutchins just takes that foul number 2, and Bailey Allen will go to the line and shoot 2.
There we go again. Stacey Ackley with the top of the 2-3 zone. Gets right in on the other side of the lane. I want to scream and shout and let it all out. And scream and shout and let it out. We say no, we are, we are, we are.
Now, now. Sets herself for her first one. The south ball free throw is no good. Ugh. One more coming for Abbott. Looking to cut this Wabash lead now to 6. Just under 3 to play in the third quarter. Abbott ready. Eyes a second one. Slides it. No good again. And the rebound to Hampton. Hampton has the basketball and now gives off to Cromer. Cromer through the center circle against Malco. Right side pass to Lewis. He gives top to Ritter. Gives to Hampton. Hampton to the elbow. Back to Lewis. Top to Cromer. Fakes a 3. Drives it. Throws up a shot from the free throw line. It's good. Timeout Wabash. It's a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo. Another great offer from RTC. For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community. Family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
Two minutes, 30 38 seconds to play in the third quarter. The Wabash lead now is back to 9, which is the biggest of the game. And after the Wabash timeout, Rochester will have it going to our right. Dan Bailey, I'm David Musselman. We're at Northfield High School tonight for this final game of the conference season for Wabash. And the blocking shot of Holland. Picked up by Cromer. Cromer throws up a shot. It's good. And on the shot, Becky Malco comes up a little lame, it looks like. She might have taken one of the gut, or not sure. Maybe favoring that left leg as well. I'm not real sure. Holland comes out of the game, and Murphy back in. And now the lead is 11 for Wabash at 38-27. 2:20 to play in the third quarter. Rochester the basketball. 2-3 zone by Wabash. Murphy on the wing. Murphy a couple of dribbles, works to the top of the key, bounce pass high on the left side to Stasiak. Stasiak around the defense, loses her footing, keeps her dribble, out to Malco, runs it right, throws up his shot, blocked by Puckett, taken away by Pollock, beat Pollock, layup is no good. Havoc kicks it out to Murphy, jumper from the elbow is in and out, no good. Stasiak with the rebound, her putback is no good, and Cromer's aboard. Four opportunities that time for Rochester, down four to Hampton, her jumper high on the glass is good. 40-27. Rochester down by 13 with a minute and a half to play in the third. 2-3 zone by Wabash. Malco drives it to the elbow. Now the paint. Seems a pass to Pollock. Jumper partially blocked by Hampton. Picked up by Hampton. Now to Cromer. Ahead to Puckett. Puckett on the block. Outside to Hampton. Right side to Cromer. Fakes the three. Drives it to the paint. Down low to Ritter. Her jumper is good. 42-27, Wabash on top with a minute to play the third. 15-point lead for Wabash all of a sudden. And it got there quickly. Stasiak drives the baseline, throws up a shot over Hampton, and Hampton just picked up foul number four, and Stasiak will go to the line to shoot two free throws.
Boy, that's what a ranked team can do to you. Rochester gets really good point-blank looks. Unable to knock three or four of them in, and Wabash turns around immediately and turns them into points.
Katie McCauley will come in after the first free throw by Hampton. She has four fouls now, and this will be the first time all game, Dan, that she has come out of the game.
I've been very impressed with Hampton and how she's played through having some foul issues. You know, she's been very safe and very smart. Still aggressive, still forcing Rochester to guard her.
But, so now what do you do? Now do you go to a triangle or a box and one?
It's going to be real interesting to see. I'm going to guess Rochester maybe is going to pick up their pressure a little bit and take Stasiak, who is face guarding it, and maybe try to throw a couple traps in there and try to get back a little bit without Hanson on the floor.
Keaton Stasiak makes both free throws. 50 seconds to play in the third.
You can see him picking up their full court pressure a little bit.
Lewis outside to Ritter with 40. 42-29 Wabash. Got a bucket. Bucket against the double team trap. Going to be caught. Oh, she gets away. Oh. Over her back. Good job by Rochester defense forcing a turnover. 34.8 to play in the third. It's 42-29. Wabash on top as the Holland comes back into the game, and she'll replace Abbott for probably the final shot of the period.
Right there you see Hampton's influence on the game from her being on the bench.
Yeah.
Just having her on the bench allowed Rochester to up the defensive pressure a little bit.
30 seconds to play in the third quarter. Holland around the defense. Wabash working in a 2-3 zone. Works in the corner to Murphy. Murphy on the high on the right side of 18. Drives it to the free throw line. Throws up a shot. We're going to have a foul to go. We're going to have a travel before the shot. And it'll go back to Wabash. 15.7 to play in the third. 42-29 Lady Apaches. Full court press now by the Rochester Lady Zebras. Ritter gets it into Cromer. Cromer over the top of the defense. To Lewis. Across the timeline with 9. Outside to Cromer with 7. Cromer dribbles away from pressure, loses the basketball to Malco. Malco with 3, layup is no good. And we're going to have a foul over the back on Wabash as the quarter comes to an end. However, Rochester will be shooting one in the bonus. 42-29, 42-29. And at the free throw line is Alexa Holland with one in the bonus for the Lady Zebras with no time on the clock here in the third. The first for the sophomore is good as it rattles in. Looking to cut this lead to 11 now with this freebie. Holland eyes the second one and lets it fly. No good. After three, Wabash leads 42-30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it is brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
Steals the basketball, goes to the basket, throws him a shot, no good, moving the rebound, the putback is good. Rochester cuts the Wabash lead to 10. 7:40 to play in the game. Hampton is on the bench for Wabash with four personal fouls. Full court press by Wabash. Stone gets it ahead to Puckett. Puckett backs away in against Pollock. Outside to Stone to the left elbow. Back quickly to Thomas. Thomas looking to dribble out of harm's way. Gives to Stone, to a cutting Thomas, gives outside to Lewis, back to Stone. Stone a couple of dribbles, top of the key against Rochester's man-to-man defense. To Puckett, her pass is knocked out of bounds by Stasiak. Boy, Dan, I can't believe Duke hit it on the head early in this game. The reason why Hampton doesn't come out is because they fall apart when she does.
Well, you can see right now on the floor, Wabash only has two players that are even looking at the basket when they catch the basketball.
Cromer gets the inbound pass, goes to the basket, throws up a shot, going to be fouled on the shot. Sugar to the line to shoot two.
And there's one of them that looks to score when she gets it.
Well, the lead went from 15, now down to 10. She's got to look. So going to the line is Claire Krober, the 5'4 junior for the Wabash Lady Apaches. Looking to extend her lead to 10. Cromer eyes the first one. Good. One more coming. No indication by Coach Bumgarner that Hampton's going to come in anytime soon. She's still on the bench. Cromer with one more for Lady Apache. Second on the way is no good as it rattles in and comes out. 44-32 Wabash. A minute gone in the fourth quarter. Malco, top of the key, backs it out. 2-3 zone by the Lady Apaches. Right side to X. High on the right side, gets the pick behind the arc, left side. Now accelerates to Stasiak behind the arc, left wing. Keaton, one dribble, out to Holland. Three on the way for the Lady Zebras, in and out, no good. And rebound tipped out around by Pollock. It'll go to Wabash.
Boy, off that dribble drive. Driving kick. Holland's got some good looks tonight, just unable to knock them in.
12-point lead for Wabash with 6:45 to play in the basketball game. Dan Bailey, I'm David Musselman. Stone to Cromer, quickly right side to Lewis, over the top of the defense to Cromer, now the left baseline to Thomas. Drives around the defense, picks up a dribble, ball loose, still loose, picked up by Stone. Wabash has it, now Malcolm steals it, now gives it ahead to Holland. Holland, right hand layup off the window, good! And the lead is back, cut to 10. Wabash with the ball up by 10, and here comes Hampton. 6-10 to play in the game. Here comes a half-court trap. Thomas with the basketball. Cross-court pass to Stone. Now gives off to Cromer. 2 minutes gone in the fourth quarter. Wabash by 10. Ball tipped by right in the hand to Cromer. Cromer around the defense. Near side to Lewis. Top of the key to Stone. She's between the rings and the volleyball line. Her bounce pass tipped away. Ball still loose. Puckett comes with it with the far side. Timeout. Wabash. Hit the 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Seconds to play in the game. Wabash is up 44-34. Rochester has given all they've got here in this basketball game. Keaton Stasiak and Becky Malko, you know, I don't know what their points are, and it doesn't matter. What they've done tonight is not going to show up tomorrow in the paper, but they have done a fantastic job defensively on Wabash.
They definitely have led defensively, face guarding two of the main players when they're in, and when those players aren't out, when Hampton's not in, and those two are in the middle of every trap, deflection. They've been doing a great job defensively.
After the Wabash timeout, they've got the basketball. Kroemer gives them the corner to Hampton. Her three is good. Now the lead is 13 for Wabash. Quickly up the floor, the Lady Zebras. Right side is X. Back to Malcolm. Quickly left side to Murph. Cross court, right to Holland. Three on the way over Hampton. No good. And the rebound tipped around. Stasiak. Wabash cocked it out of bounds. It'll stay with Rochester baseline left.
Pollock is having herself a quiet, very good game. She's had a great flare pick there to get Holland wide open. You know, she's making it difficult for Puckett to score inside.
Holland fouled by Hampton, and she is done. How about that heads-up play? The backs are to Holland, who's bringing her in. Holland bounces it off the back of the Wabash Lady Apache, gets the basketball, tries to go up on a reverse layup, and Hampton fouls her, and she is done. Look out.
Well, I tell you, Holland hasn't had a very good game shooting the basketball so far, but that might be one of the plays that makes this game a little more interesting.
Oh, boy.
That was a very good basketball play.
Heck, it's the first one. She'll have one more. The lead is down to 12.
And, you know, she's been in the middle of these traps out front, too, getting deflections and layups. If she can get herself going at the free throw line here, that has a tendency to lead to some longer ones going in.
She hits both. Rochester will use a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Fifteen to play in the game. Wabash's lead is down to 11 at 47-36. The best player for Wabash is out of the game, and the trap is going to produce a foul. I thought Bailey Abbott tied up Stone on the far side, but she's going to pick up a foul. Rochester will shoot two free throws from here on out, and Wabash has one more foul to get before they start shooting. Dan Bailey, I'm David Musselman.
A little overzealous there on the trap. They had her in real good position. Just reached in instead of trying to tip it on the way out.
Wabash with the basketball up by 11. Here comes the half-court trap. Stone, near side to Kroemer. Now left side to River, back to Kroemer. Kroemer holds the Stone middle of the floor. Stone dribbles to her right. Got to get rid of it. Gets the double team. Ball's loose. Going to be tied up. Rochester going to get it on the turnover.
There's a very simple difference. They had the same trap the last possession when Abbott got called for a foul. The difference was the second time, instead of reaching in, they just played big and deflected it on the way out, and somebody else picked up the ball from the backside.
Rochester forces another turnover, looking to cut this lead inside at double digits on this drive. Dayton crossover dribble out to Becky Malco, three right wing, in and out, no good. Stacey after the rebound, her putback no good, and the rebound to Wabash. Ritter almost traveled, and the Rochester fans wanted it.
Offensive rebound not turning into points
for
Rochester.
You're right.
That's the story of the whole game.
Lewis, the bucket, outside to Cromer, who throws it away. Rochester going to get it back. 4:08 to play in the game. Wabash clinging, I think I can say that word, clinging to an 11-point lead.
Boy, if you can cling to an 11-point lead, it's definitely true because they look disheveled, uncertain.
Malco step back three, no good. Ball loose. Ball still loose. The scramble board's going to be tied up, and Wabash going to get it. Boy, we have gotten all sorts of good looks behind the arc and just can't get it to fall. Under 4 to play in the game. Wabash still up by 11 to 47-36. And Lewis gets the inbound pass, and she'll take it across the timeline right. Here comes the run and jump defense. Lewis, near side to Thomas, outside to Ritter, back to Thomas to the baseline. Thomas to Lewis. Rochester in a box and one. Pass is tipped away and stolen by Pollock, who gives to Malco. Malco runs the right side, caught up by the defense, top to Holland, three on the way, top of the key, nope. And the rebound hauled in by Wabash, and now Cromer has it.
Well, I'd like to see Rochester get the ball inside to Pollock. That's where a lot of their inside-out good looks come from. Another opportunity maybe to get some points at the free throw line, too.
Shot no good by Wabash. Ball tipped around, and it's going to be last touch by Rochester Stasiak. It'll stay with Wabash baseline left. 3:09 to play in the game. Wabash up 47-36, and Coach Stasiak will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Ladies Hear Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Nine to play in the game. Wabash up 47-36. That'll be Lady Apache basketball baseline left, going to our left. Thomas gets the inbounds pass. Now top of the key to Lewis. Lewis holds above her head, out to Cromer. Cromer over the top of the defense to Thomas. Thomas a couple of dribbles. Dribbles away from Stasiak. Picks up her dribble, gives out. And oh my goodness gracious. And Alexa Holland just bull rushed and ran over Lewis near the timeline, and it'll be a foul on Rochester, and Wabash will shoot free throws from here on out.
Well, since Hampton went out, the only opportunity Wabash has even come close to scoring is maybe getting to the free throw line.
Yeah, you're right. It's been a long time since they've scored it. Double team against in the backcourt. Now we're going to have a foul on Stasiak, which is going to send Cromer to the line for one of the bonus. Coach Stasiak thought it was going to be a charge from the elbow, and Stasiak picks up the foul. 2:45 to play in the game, 47-36. And going to the line is Claire Cromer, looking to push this 11-point lead to 12 and maybe 13. Free throw by Cromer is good. One more coming for the junior. 2:45 to play in the game with a 12-point lead for Wabash. And last report, Kylie Hampton has fouled out at about the 4-minute mark. Second one is good again by Cromer. 48-36. 49-36. Rochester down by 13 with 2:40 to play in the game. Murphy, left side wing, three on the way is no good. And the rebound to Puckett. Puckett then has her pass kicked out of bounds by Holland. And Wabash going to keep possession. Boy, those outside shots who has fallen all year for the Lady Zebras, they can't buy a bucket tonight from 19 feet.
Unfortunately, that's usually how it goes. The basket starts to shrink.
You're right.
The more you miss.
Pass is tipped away and out of bounds. Last touch by Wabash. They're going to get it back to Rochester. 13-point lead, and I can guarantee if you coach Bumgarner, it feels like maybe a 2 or 3 point lead. 2:20 to play in the game. Wabash up by 13. Rochester basketball going to our right. Down low to Pollock, and she is fouled the dump pass by Puckett. That's going to send B to the line to shoot two. So B. Pollock in the line to shoot two with 2:14 to play in the game. Rochester down by 13. And the senior eyeing her first one.
I think if Rochester gets a chance to look at this tape at all, getting the ball into Pollock, not necessarily for scoring opportunities for her, but getting it in there, you get fouls like this, you get a chance to score with the clock stop, and you get those perimeter defenders turning their head for the inside-out shot.
Yeah. Second one's made, and then Becky Malco steals the inbound pass, gives to Pollock, outside to Murphy, leaning her in the paint, no good, rebound tipped around, and now we're going to have a foul to reach in, and B will go back to the line to shoot two.
That was a little more of a high post look, but still it got the ball to Pollock 8 feet out. She made a good pass, got an offensive rebound. Now it's just a matter of knocking some chops.
Yeah, pretty nice. 2:05 to play in the game. B has an opportunity to cut this or knock this down to a 10-point lead with two freebies here. B, first one, good. One more coming for the senior, looking to cut this lead to 10. 2:05 to play in the game. Pollock ready. Eyes the second one. Let her fly. Good again. 49-39. Wabash on top with 2:05 to play in the game. Puckett gets it in to Thomas, and she is fouled by Pollock, who just ripped the ball away from her. And that's going to send Thomas to the line for one of the bonus. And B. Pollock has picked up foul number three. And that's going to send Lindsay Thomas, a 5'7 senior, at the line for one and the bonus.
Well, that looks like a very good play.
Yeah, looks like
Pollock.
A clean rip. You're right. So Thomas at the line for one and the bonus, a 2:04 to play in the game. Looking to push this to 11-point lead. First on the way is good. Well, one thing that Wabash has done well tonight when they've given the opportunity is hit free throws.
You know, that is a huge difference in the game. Not just the score, but the mentality of making free throws. What it does to the other team when they see you knocking them down.
Thomas has hit both of them to push his lead back 12. 2 minutes to play in the game. Murphy left side. Murph drives in the paint. Boulder on the way over Puck. No good. Rebound hit for, fought for. Falco has it. X on the right wing. Spread over the defense. Good! Timeout, Rochester. 51-42 Wabash. A minute 47 to play in the game. It's a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball. 92.1 WROI. minute 47 to play in regulation. Rochester's cut the Wabash lead to 9 after a big three-point bomb by Holland to make it 51-42. Thomas gets the basketball across the timeline, drives it left, gets outside, now to Lewis, toes the top of the defense to Puckett, but Lewis is going to be fouled on the pass, and she'll go to the line to shoot one of the opponents. I believe Holland picked up the foul, will be her fourth. A minute 39 to play in the game. Wabash by 9. And at the free throw line is Jacqueline Lewis, a 5'8 senior for the Wabash Lady Apaches. It's one and a bonus. First one. Nope. Rebound. Offense. It's a putback, but Renner is no good. But a foul coming in Rochester. Good heavens. A ginormous offensive board by Renner. Gets Abbott to pick up her third foul, but more importantly, she'll go back to the free throw line in a minute 37 to play in the game, up by 9. Ritter's first one, no good.
Perfect. For Rochester, you got exactly what you wanted. A missed free throw, the right person shooting the free throw, and just couldn't come up with a rebound.
Yep, I agree. Ritter with one more, looking to push this lead back to 10 for her Lady Apache. Second was good. 52-42, Wabash. Rochester on the run in the minute 35. Holland, right wing, crossover dribble, step back. Now works the left side. Becky Malko on the wing. Her pass knocked away and stolen by Wabash. Crummer has it. Crummer then is fouled by Holland, and she is done. A minute 23 to play in the game. Wabash by 10. And at the free throw line will be Miss Automatic Claire Cromer, who will shoot 2 free throws.
The natural tendency of high school kids when you're chasing 10 points with a minute and a half is, especially when you've got three-point shooters, is to think you got to shoot threes to get back in the game. And, you know, one strength I think Rochester has had tonight is getting penetration into the lane, and they've kind of gotten away from that the last few possessions.
Yeah. So after the foul, Wabash and Claire Cromer will be at the free throw line to shoot 2. So Alexa Holland is done for the night, and Abbott comes into the game for her.
Now, if we're talking about Rochester wanting the right person at the free throw line, Cromer is not her.
Yeah, good call.
She is 6-6 on the night.
Cromer has 2. First one is good. One more coming for Cromer. Again, if Wabash wins this, they will win the TRC outright. They're up by 11 right now, the minute 23 to play in the game. Cromer's second one. The shooter connects on both of them. 12-point lead for Wabash. Malco runs. 80 seconds of play in the game. Murphy dribbles to the baseline. Pull-up jumper from 15 feet is no good. Rebound to Cromer. She's on a breakaway, and now we'll pull it out. And she loses the handle. Stasiak saves her going out of bounds to Cromer. Outside to Lewis, back to Cromer, and Coach Stasiak just picked up a technical. So Cromer will go to the line to shoot 2 shots with Wabash leading by 12 at 54-42.
So in that possession, Cromer gets a steal, breakaway layup, like a smart point guard, pulls it out, loses the handle, going out of bounds. Rochester saves the ball right back into her. I mean, just a crazy turn of events.
Cromer's second technical shot is good, and now the lead is out to 14 for Wabash. 62 seconds to play in the game. And it'll be interesting to see if Coach Stasiak will foul here or what he'll do with time running down here on the conference season for Wabash and for him, for that matter. Cromer with the basketball, Rochester in a trap. They run and jump, Cromer with it. And now we're going to have an offensive foul on Wabash, but legal screen on Puckett, I believe. What? 52.8 to play in the game. It'll be Rochester basketball on the illegal screen. Free throws. Yeah. 52.8 to play in the game. Wabash by 14, and it'll be Rochester basketball at the timeline going to our right. Dan Bailey, I'm David Musselman. Now goes across the timeline with 50, drives it to the free throw line, in the paint, comes down to Abbott. Abbott, shot is blocked by Puckett, but she's going to pick up a foul. She is done. And Bailey Abbott will go to the line to shoot two for Rochester.
And right there again, we see that penetration by Malco into the lane. Wabash just all night long not able to keep Rochester guards out of the lane. She dumps it down, and Abbott gets a couple really important free throws.
46 seconds to play in the game. Rochester down by 14, and Bailey Abbott on the line to shoot two shots for Rochester. Abbott eyes the first one, lets it fly. It's good. One more coming for the junior. Looking to cut this lead to 12. Alexa Holland has found out for Rochester. Puckett and Hampton for Wabash. Abbott eyes the second one, lets it fly. No good. And the long rebound to Ritter. Ritter has it tipped out of bounds by Pollock, and it will stay with Wabash underneath the Rochester basket with 43.3 to play in the game. Wabash up by 13. Ritter looks to get it in, looking for Cromer, but gets it into Thomas, who is fouled by Bailey Abbott, and that's going to send Thomas to the free throw line to shoot two. Boy, Rochester could have got a couple shots knocked down at about the three-minute mark with Hampton on the bench. I think they approached the last 2 minutes in a different mindset.
You know, their half-court trapping pressure, very, very effective. You've got teams in here scouting Rochester. They are not looking forward to facing that half-court trap because Rochester is very effective in that. They got to a point where they had to use it in a situation that was pretty desperate.
15-point lead now for Wabash as Malcolm comes down, throws up a shot too hard off the glass. Thomas the rebound down to Cromer. Cromer throws a dribble around the defense. Picks up her dribble now, gets a double team, and is fouled by Murphy. That's going to send Cromer back to the line to shoot two. With 30 seconds to play in the game, Wabash is going to win the conference with an undefeated 7-0 mark. And Rochester's streak of losing to Wabash continues. Cromer with two for Wabash. Cromer's free throw is good. Still have one more. Looking to push this lead now to 17 with the next freebie. Derek Romer, the 5'4 junior, eyes the second one, lets it fly. Good again. And Coach Stasiak will empty his bench, as will Coach Bumgardner.
We talked about Cromer really controlling the fourth quarter. She's 10% from the free throw line just in the fourth quarter alone. That's definitely what you like to see out of your point guard.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, she came in. She was given a opportunity to take this team on her shoulders and hand it fouled out, and she did not disappoint any Apache fans. And Rochester uses a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Seconds to play in the game. 60-43 Wabash. Odell's three is no good. Rebound to Wabash with 15. And the Lady Apaches are going to win this one here at Northfield High School tonight and win the conference undefeated as they defeat the Rochester Lady Zebras by a final of 60-43. Back with post-game thoughts after this on 92.1 WROI.